2019 is done, so I thought it'd be a great time to look back on my first few months involved at CIPS as editor of the blog and highlight a few of those articles and blogs that I think have really spoken to me this year and I think you might enjoy too. First off, I'm only looking at blogs that have been written originally for CIPS. We do repost a lot of really fantastic articles written by CIPS faculty and members and published elsewhere first of all, and those are always worth reading and I've learned an awful lot from them. However, in this case I think it's only fair to confine our collection to those that were originally written for CIPS. Second, this isn't a list of the best written, the best researched, or anything like that. There's so much great stuff coming out of CIPS all the time, and it wouldn't be possible for me to pick the best or even to try and rank them at all. So I'm simply choosing the ones that I subjectively have a soft spot for. And the basis of this really are my own opinions, and in particular, those blogs that have either taught me about a topic I didn't know very much about at all before reading the blog. Second, those blogs that have taken a topic that I feel like I knew something about before and helped me look at it in a different way or given me something to think about, which is I wouldn't have otherwise done. So my first highlight is Mark Salter's account of Arctic sovereignty. This is a fascinating first-hand account based on his own research going up with the Canadian Navy into the far north. He talks, it introduces a lot of key ideas about sovereignty and claims over territory in the far north, about the impact of climate change, and poignantly, the relationship between Canada and the Indigenous peoples of the far north, and makes the author makes a really compelling argument, I think, that Canada can and should do more to improve those relations. Second, I'm going to highlight the blog on the paradoxes of the global radical right by several colleagues from CIPS and based on a fantastic research project which is ongoing. This is a topic, of course, that many of us will be familiar with if it's through the Trump administration in the United States, through Brexit from where I'm from, or in terms of international relations, the rise of Jair Bolsonaro, the near rise of Marine Le Pen, and so on and so on, so many different examples. This blog really gives us a lot here in terms of telling us a bit more about what this means, breaking it down into five key lessons, and highlighting how the global radical right is sometimes self-contradictory, very fast-moving and innovative, and so on. Really, if you're interested in contemporary politics at an international level or in terms of the presidential election next in 2020, then this is a must-read. My third pick is Jacqueline Best's blog on economic exceptionalism. I had the pleasure of editing and reposting several articles by Professor Best this year, all of which were really interesting. But this one in particular is something she wrote specifically for CIPS, and also includes a really interesting video that she produced in order to make what she argues much more accessible to non-economists. It's a really fascinating blog, not least for me, because having worked in international relations myself with some work on critical security studies, I'm most familiar with the idea of exceptionalism being a political issue, one where, or a security issue, one where particular threats are taken out of the norm, made exceptional, and how the political environment adapts or changes in order to deal with that and what the repercussions of that are. But Professor Best takes this same concept about exceptionalism and shows us how economic policymakers do something similar, and it really has an effect of which is ripples throughout society and impacts us all. Really, really fascinating stuff and definitely worth a read. So fourth, I'm cheating a little bit and I'm picking three linked blogs, two which have already published, and the third one is coming out early in 2020. These are by James Trottier on US North Korean relations. And again, they're based on his own personal experience and knowledge, having been a diplomat and working with the North Koreans and with the Americans. And I think these blogs are really interesting. They, first off, it tells a lot about the history of the relationship between North Korea and the United States and how that's developed. Then in particular, then he looks at how under the presidencies of Kim Jong-un and Donald Trump, this relationship has transformed in many different ways. And finally, in the forthcoming blog, he's going to make a few predictions and suggestions about what to expect in terms of this relationship going forward. So my final highlight is a blog by Farhad Razi and Ofer Selektar on Iran and on Iranian foreign policy, and a really interesting comparison between a contemporary Iran and the former Soviet Union. This is one of the blogs that you read and you realize that there's a totally different way of thinking about a topic than you might have otherwise done. What I really like about it is that it diverges from the traditional dichotomy of good guy versus bad guy that you often see in a lot of opinion pieces, in news reporting, and indeed in some academic writing. And rather, it tries to dissect or deconstruct how Iran's foreign policy and domestic policy mesh, how the distribution of resources Iran trying to achieve its foreign policy goals if affects its domestic security or the security of the regime. A really fascinating account, a comparison that I wouldn't have thought of otherwise, and is absolutely definitely worth a read. So 2019 is done. It's been a remarkable, eventful year in terms of world politics, but a fantastic year for CIPS with incredible events, really fascinating stuff. I can only tell you that 2020 is going to get even better. So please keep watching the blog, keep checking out the website, come to our events, follow us on Twitter, follow us on Facebook, or retweet us, get in touch, get involved. Most of all, best wishes to you, your families, and everybody's important to you for 2020.